lunch pail, or the sandwich you packed. And let Les and Freddie S. bring you jokes and nostalgia mixed in with important information about medicine, food, dating, or just the stuff you need to help that bagel go down nice and smoothly. And if you have a story about anything you want to share, a bad date, a movie review, or just the strangest thing that happened to you at work, call in and join the fun toll-free at 1-800-889-0267. Right now, sit back and let's start the lunch break. Freddie S. and Les are ready, so here are the boys.
The juicy. Well, let's say good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Freddie. Yes,
good
how
to
was,
be.
How
good
was your
to
surgery?
Be back. It wasn't my surgery, but that's okay. Everything worked out really well. Good
so
to
nice
be back.
That everybody's back.
Yeah.
The boys are back together.
And a girl was with me on Friday. We had a great show with some hotties, right? It was called Ladies' Day.
It was Ladies' Day.
And we're trying to figure out who was the hottest one there.
I have to tell you, I really don't think I'm short until I stand in a picture. And I had not too short of heels on. And I was still really short.
Well, I'm 6 foot. Sonny has to be 6'1". And Amanda was about your size, right? A little taller than you?
She was in the picture, she was way taller. I never think of anyone as taller than me. I guess that's just my perception that I'm tall.
You never think anybody taller than you.
But
everybody's
clearly
taller.
I'm not. See that? It's all perception.
First of all, how tall are you?
I'm only 5'1".
Okay.
But
when
I got a dog that's taller than
me. When we all sit down, we all have the same height.
We're all the same when we're sitting. You know, when you're sitting down or laying down, you're all the same.
And why don't you introduce this very pretty lady?
We have a very beautiful guest with us, Ms. Tracy Kawa.
Hi, everyone.
Hey, Tracy.
Thank you for having me here.
Well, we ran out of guests.
Oh, great.
We never run out of guests. Tracy's awesome.
You, it's great to be invited by default.
No, but I'll tell you, I spoke to Tracy, and she's an exciting lady. Tell us what you do.
Oh, hold on a second.
Why can't
hold
I find
on, no,
out
hold
now?
On a second. Hold on a second. We're not doing it that way.
Why?
First, because we got to tell people where we're at, where we're playing.
We're right here sitting.
No, we're not.
Okay.
You can catch today's show on Facebook.
Yes.
On
Facebook
TV
live
production.
Stream, right?
Live stream.
Yes, we're live stream.
Live stream.
You know, I found out Friday.
Well, hold it. Where else?
AM2 TV Productions.
AM2 TV Productions
where
will
else?
Be taped delayed. We're going to, what do you mean where else?
Oh.
Where else do you want to be? We could be seen in New York. We could be seen, I heard, in Atlanta.
Yeah.
But live,
why?
We are AM2 TV Productions.
You haven't been alive since we've been doing this
on
show.
On Facebook. Yeah.
Video live.
Video live.
And look how nice Les looks today.
Yeah,
he's all dressed
I know.
Up again.
Why is he getting dressed all of a sudden? That's a bad sign.
Because my little pretty lady that said how handsome I was.
He looked so handsome in his Robert Graham last week.
Yes. You know, how did you know it was Robert Graham?
You know.
Jewish.
You know.
I'm going to wear another Robert Graham tomorrow.
Okay.
All right.
Wow.
Is there a reason? Are you leaving his money in your will or something?
No, I decided that when I come here with wonderful looking, well-dressed.
Oh, hold it. You decided that after 6 months, today is our
six-month right.
anniversary?
Happy anniversary.
Yeah. What does that mean?
You've been here for six months.
Oh, did we make money?
Yay!
I never said we made money.
Okay, anyone that wants to talk to any of us, it's 800-889-0267.
Tell us how you think Les' shirt looks.
Tell me how I look. I look better, Les. Yeah, I was just expensive.
So you're not dressed like a Swiss sock. You come in here with smoke.
No, you know what it is? There's no
I'm gonna tell you, I gotta complain.
Like there's no air conditioning in the men's locker room.
On Wednesday, you made me take pictures, and I put my hand on your back. You were soaked, soaked,
really?
Soaked. Yes. That's when Dylan was here.
Yeah.
I said no. I don't want to stand next to him. I mean, he was soaked. It was like he took a shower. He forgot to towel off.
Really? It gets a little warm in here, I have to tell you. That's why I have to put the air down.
Well, you know, you work out. You work out?
I work out.
Okay, so you work out when you get changed. Most gyms, it's not air conditioned in the room.
Really?
I think
in Plantation, they need to have air conditioning in their gym.
No kidding.
I think you should tell them.
I did.
And?
They said open the door.
You weren't at the gym. You were here. Sweating like I've never seen you sweat.
That's unusual because I always shout. You know what happens?
He forgot his towel.
Well, you know what it is?
I don't know what it was.
I went into the steam room And that's the worst thing to do because, and what happens is they don't have cold water in the showers, they have hot water. So you're schwitzing. Schwitzing for like, by the time I get here. So I decided today I was going to do something different. Here's what I did.
What'd you do?
After I worked out, I decided not to go into the steam room. And I went outside and I had myself a protein drink, sat out there, talked to the ladies like I always do. And I was nice and cool then. And then when I took my shower, and I was fine.
You're much more relaxed.
Yeah.
Your body temperature came down.
Right. That's exactly what
Well, maybe not, but.
Well, some of the girls. You see what Amanda looks like? There's like 10 girls that look better. Well, I shouldn't say. I think to me, Amanda's one of the hottest women I've ever seen.
She's beautiful.
And she knows how to work out. And she, look, like she said, 70% of it is working out. No, 70% is eating.
Eating.
And 30% is working out.
Listen, I've never met a woman that you didn't consider hotter than the next. Hotter, hotter, hotter.
I could think
that's
whatever.
Nice.
I could think whatever I want, but I don't do anything to. What's the word, doc?
You're
a doc.
To implement.
Thank you. Implement my feeling.
We were out with some friends the other night, and we're thinking, where'd you guys go? I went to the restroom after dinner. I came back and couldn't find them. They were having a little bit of a discussion that her husband was looking at someone in a painted dress, and he says, "What do you mean? I'm married. I'm not dead."
Right.
So they were having a discussion. How his eyeballs were kind of popping out of his head because he was checking her out.
Well, hold on a second. They left the table?
Well, we were finished with dinner. We were getting ready to go.
Oh, I do the same thing her husband does.
So they were arguing because the guy was looking at some other...
They were discussing.
Discussing what?
They were discussing his eyeballs were looking.
I'll tell you one thing. I seen Lester around his wife one time. He doesn't look anywhere.
Really?
He almost tripped and broke his neck on a crack of the floor. I said, "You want to look down?" He says, "No, I don't look nowhere. I look straight."
Where I get into trouble when I go to Whole Foods where I live.
There he goes.
A woman will come up, they put her arms around me, kiss me on the lips, and my wife goes like this, "Starbucks or the gym?" "Oh, gym. Okay."
Nice. She knows. She's confident, though.
I grew up in the 60s. I did everything I was supposed to do. I got it all out of my system.
He was supposed to do and not supposed to do.
I don't think he got it all out of his system either.
But I've in 45 years, I've looked, I hugged, and that was it. I have never, ever, ever bring in lie detectors, anything. I've never
what
cheated on my wife.
What else are you expecting to do?
Never cheated on my wife.
That's very nice.
Not once.
And that's very respectful.
Thank you.
And that leads us to our discussion before.
Tracy, don't buy any of this.
He likes that New York
honestly,
Tracy.
Don't buy and nothing. This is nothing, honey.
I'm serious.
Don't buy none of this.
Look at him looking
guy,
at you.
I know this guy 17 years.
Look at that face.
I know this guy 17 years. Nada. Dr. Ihart.
Yes.
Are you buying this?
No.
Thank you. Don't buy any of this, honey. Because this guy.
Have I ever hit on you?
Yes, every day.
That sounded like you asked him if you ever hit on him,
no,
and he said yes every
my
day.
My phone is exploding.
Tracy,
because
it's crazy about me.
Freddie's crazy about you?
Now he's going to play that part.
That makes you crazy.
Because of our mutual respect and love, he went and got a penis implant. Could you show it to us? They said you said
TMI. TMI.
Could I introduce Tracy now?
No, not yet.
Please.
But honestly, if an older woman is with a younger guy and she meets him at the gym, she's a cougar.
Mm-hmm.
But there is no name like that for an older man and a younger woman.
I told you I was. It's called Lucky.
You call him a leopard.
It's Lucky.
A leopard.
Leopard.
A lucky leopard.
What's the opposite of a cougar?
A barracuda.
No, barracuda sounds like a woman still.
I don't think animals have opposites.
Well,
but
I'm saying
like a
butterfly.
Tiger has a lion.
A butterfly.
Tiger has a lion.
He's a bumblebee, baby.
Giraffe has a hippo.
We can start a whole new trend. We can just label it right here.
What would you like to label? You're talking about a young guy going after an older woman?
No, an
older guy going after a younger woman.
Well, I can tell you what it is.
It's a silver fox.
Silver fox, okay.
Oh, that's nice, actually.
Well, look at it.
What is it with people in this booth that know everything? Between you and Connecticut.
We pay these people a lot of money.
It must be.
You're busting the budget, baby.
A silver fox.
Silver
Did you know
fox.
That?
There you go.
Hey, Tracy.
I know.
I've never even heard of that.
Silver fox.
You look
it's kind
like
of much more
giraffe.
Eloquent than a cougar.
you look like a bald eagle.
There you go.
It sounds kind of sexy, actually, a silver fox.
Mm-hmm. You find that sexy?
The name is kind of sexy.
But you know what it is?
I got a question for Mrs. Sexy over here.
if you're
at a restaurant, right? And you're having your meal, finishing up, and this gorgeous woman walks by. And your husband sort of looks in that direction.
Yes.
What do you do?
I call him on it.
You do?
Oh, my wife.
100%.
Oh, no. At the table?
Yeah.
Really?
Although, I have to tell you, we had some really nice-looking gentlemen on our show last week, and he called me on that. He said, "What's up with you and all these cute guys on your show?" I said, "They're good-looking guys." He said, "So yeah, I can't look at a woman." He goes, "But you could look at the guys on your show."
No. One thing is looking. Another thing is talking about it, because you started saying, "Wow, I got good-looking guys around me."
Well, it's no different than him looking and going, "Look, she was painted in her dress."
Well, I'm saying, like, define look. My define look. What does look mean?
You see
are
my
you
finger?
Ogling?
You see my finger?
Or are you just glancing?
You see my finger? That's looking.
Are you noticing? Okay, if you're noticing a beautiful woman, like a beautiful car, then right. That's looking. Mm-hmm. If you're standing there and, you know, your spouse is cleaning the drool off of your shoes, that is no longer looking.
First of all, the other thing I had to ask is, women get dressed up, you get dolled up.
Yeah.
And you get dolled up to be looked at, right?
Oh, yeah.
Right? I mean, yeah. Am I wrong or am I right?
I'm going to say, Fred, you're 100% right. They don't get dressed up for their husbands. They get dressed up to get looked at.
They get dressed up for
everybody
else.
Yes, well, exactly right.
Well, we get dressed.
That's a bell.
That's his bell.
They get dressed up for other women so that the other women look at them and we're like, wow, she's put together really well.
Exactly.
You see this bridge behind me? $1.99 if you want to buy it. Let me know.
Okay.
Women get dressed because they want to be noticed.
Of course.
When you go to dinner.
Or we want to feel good about ourselves.
But when a guy looks at you, do you feel good?
Sock, I wouldn't really
absolutely.
Feel that great.
When a guy looks at you,
don't you feel good?
You feel good.
It's nice to be noticed.
Right.
But I don't want anybody drooling or bumping into a wall.
She's New York. She knows what to do.
It should be the two guys from Brooklyn, the girl from Flatbush, and the other girl from... Where are you from, Nutta?
I'm actually from Brooklyn.
I was born in Texas, but I've...
Oh, my God, I know no one from Texas.
My daughter was born in Dallas.
I was in Galveston. My father was in the Coast Guard, that's why.
Oh, your father? That's a Jewish Navy. Where all the Jews go... Oh, let me tell you.
In Galveston?
When we got drafted... Okay, when I was drafted, all the other guys were drafted because we were in that number. I'm an old guy, you can tell that. So what
He's
happened?
A silver fox.
Okay, baby. So what happened was, I get my number and I say to my buddy Eric, I said, "Eric, we got to go down to the Coast Guards because they don't do anything; they just jump in the water and save people." He says, "Good idea." We go down to the Coast Guards. He gets accepted because they took all the tests and said, "There's something wrong with you." I said, "Oh yeah, I know that." He said, "But I want to send you to one of our doctors. I think you have something in your blood causing you to have colitis." Well, it was Crohn's disease, anyhow.
Okay.
So that's even better.
Did you know you had it before you went for that physical?
No, but I was happy I had it because I would not go to Vietnam.
Yeah.
I would go as a conscientious objector.
Via who?
Vietnam. That was the year we were, you know, punchy sticks.
They should have sent you. We would have won the war a lot quicker. They said, "We give up. Just get this maniac
There's
out of here."
No, understand one thing. There's not a Jewish guy on the battlefield. He's either a stenographer. he's writing down how many people are dead. Jewish guy. I'm a doctor. Buddy went in what's the terminology?
My father-in-law was over as a flight doctor. It's like a flight surgeon.
He went in as a rabbi.
Get out of here.
He would do the services on
Was he a rabbi?
Oh, God, no.
Who was a rabbi?
My friend went into the army, and he said, "I just want to let you know."
I thought you went in as a rabbi.
No, what he said was, that, you know, there's a lot of Catholic people here, and there's a lot of...
You know, it's a federal offense to avoid the draft and making up lies, so you should be real careful what you're saying right now.
Oh, they gave me 4F.
They could give you 10F. They could take you to jail, too.
I was...
And I
Tracy,
don't. I would hate to have to...
So
Tracy, you understand what we have here. Mr... He's Ihart, Dr. Ihart.
Dr. Ihart.
This guy's just the BS king of the world. So be careful.
I just think he's got a lot of stories.
I grew up in the 60s. I mean, understand where I grew up from.
He was a hippie.
I wasn't a hippie.
Are you still smoking grass?
Oh, I haven't had grass since I married my wife.
Yeah, right.
I haven't had a smoking grass.
Who was here the other day? Eric.
Oh, Eric.
Grand Transformation. You told me that you used to hang out with him in the back and smoke weed. You know, you're unbelievable. The things I learned about you. 17 years, you would think I know something.
Look how long you guys have been friends.
Too long.
Yeah, well, you know.
17 years.
Well, he's the brains and I'm the big mouth. Can I say who Tracy is now? She's been on the air now for 20
you're
minutes.
You're not going to introduce her. We're going to have...
Tracy, I'm on your side.
We're going to have Dawn introduce her.
I mean, I'm trying to get you... I mean, you're talking. Everyone says, "Who's that lady that has that nice
voice?" Everybody knows Tracy's here.
Let me just say one thing.
Let me get back to... Okay. When men get older, when men get older, they're like more distinguished, and women find that very attractive. When women get older, they think, here's a key word, they think they're not attractive. I like older women because they have experience. You can talk to them. They understand what's going on. So when I see...
That's why he likes me, because we can talk.
Yeah,
Where's he going with this?
Well, first of all,
Tracy's not older. You're not older. I mean, what's he going with?
I'm not talking about
We're
you.
We're older than 27.
Take the girl that's on Thursday. That's with you. What's her name? Lorena?
Lorena Anderson?
Yeah, she told me how old she was.
You gotta be real careful. She'll take a gun and shoot
you. No, she told me how old she was. This is a woman that's beautiful and very bright.
Lorena, I'm sorry. I didn't put him up to this.
I think she's very pretty. She's a very bright woman. You can sit and talk. Well, what I'm saying to you is those women I find more attractive than 27-year-olds.
What are you going to do? You're going to go after the bodybuilder you brought in here Friday who's 22 years old?
I'm not going after anybody, but I mean, guys, look at the... I mean, these women...
Les, I've seen you look at 20... 21, oh 31, I'm not 45, dead. 57, 97.
It just depends what you're looking for.
I was at a restaurant.
No. Guys don't think that way.
No, well, I was at a restaurant with my wife. And
you hear this? Women think that way, but men don't.
Men don't think that way.
We think so differently than you guys.
Oh, please. I love the line.
I'm going to introduce you.
Tracy, we're going to introduce you right now. I love the line where guys says, I look into your eyes. Yeah, right.
Well, yeah, wait. Right. I look into your eyes and want to know if I could get into your pants.
That's exactly it. That's right. Nice, Nutter.
Here comes the music. This is the Lester music. I'm looking in your eyes.
Look at this. Okay.
I look at your ears to see if you have two.
You got to understand men. Okay, you got to... Nutter, you tell me...
Okay, what's the secret to men, please?
Okay, it takes 9 months for a man...
To get pregnant.
No, to get out of the, to get out of the vagina, right?
Oh, my God.
It takes the rest of his life to try to get back in.
Think about that.
And that's not to say that women don't come out the same way. So that don't make no sense.
Can we introduce Tracy now?
And on that note...
You want to introduce Tracy now that Tracy's all red and embarrassed?
Yes, Tracy's a little embarrassed.
No, I don't think Tracy's embarrassed.
Tracy's a little embarrassed.
we'll let her catch
How
her
are
breath.
You, Tracy? Welcome to the show.
Welcome to our show, Tracy. We have Tracy Kawa. Tracy Kawa and I have been... We've been working on business development together for the past few months. Mm-hmm. And what I love about Tracy is, like I told you guys, I have all these ideas in my head, and you execute them here. She executes my ideas on paper, which is amazing.
That is amazing.
And she helps on social media. She helps redefine yourself. So her area of expertise, as I've been working with her, is redefining and reinventing yourself with purpose and passion after 40. So if you're in a different career and looking for another career, if you're just trying to find something different, she's got this amazing assessment tool she created.
Oh, wow.
Which...
You have to be 40?
No.
Not necessarily.
Just after 40.
Right, so it can also be like...
We used to first... One, I used it for my niece coming out of high school going to college because I wanted her to feel empowered going to college.
Or coming out of college and looking for that ideal job in the workforce, which is so difficult to find these days.
Oh, God, yes.
So, Tracy, let me ask you a question. Is it better to believe in yourself and create something of you, or is it better to go work for McDonald's for minimum wage?
Wow, that is a great question.
It's a loaded question
because you can look at that... You can look at that so many different ways. So, on the one hand, yes, I mean, there are people who have that entrepreneurial spirit. And there are people who have that entrepreneurial spirit and who are unable to execute. So if you have all these gifts and talents within you and you want to create something of yourself, then you have to know what type of team you need around you in order to implement and make this happen and bring your idea to fruition.
You understand what fruition means, right?
What?
You understand what fruition means, right?
Okay, no, but I'll look it up later.
You know, and the other half of your question is, should somebody just go out and get, you know, your basic job. I mean, your basic jobs are what make the world go round. You know, we need that person at McDonald's. We need that person driving that truck.
Yeah.
We need that person.
No, absolutely.
You know,
somebody's got to pick
what's
somebody's
the
gotta
answer?
Pick the apples. I understand that.
Or we've
but
got no apple
buy
pie.
The apples.
Yep.
You know, the hard thing about people is that they don't realize you have a gift.
Yep.
And if you believe in that gift, and I don't mean just talking about it. That's talk is cheap. I mean doing something about it.
And you're cheap.
And I'm very cheap.
But you know what's interesting about that? Some people don't even know the gifts they have.
That's right.
That's exactly true. I totally believe that.
Yeah.
Do I have a gift?
Yes.
You have the gift of gab.
That's what, and I'm a sales guy.
Yes. There you go.
That's why I tell you, don't believe anything
awesome.
He says. He'll give you...
I have never lied to anyone that I was trying to sell to.
I'm not sure how to take that, because that's like a really vast, broad...
Wow, I didn't
like
train.
That pause, that silence in the room.
I don't even know how I came out with that one.
That one
that
is...
That was good.
That's
a broad spectrum of people.
And you're a nice bro, too.
We bring good broads on the show, right?
Listen,
you know what I like about Tracy? Let me tell you what you could. Tracy's got that voice that you just want to listen to. It's like not authoritative, it's just very soothing, and there's something to back it up. That's why I like you.
Thank you.
I like the way you speak. I like the way you speak.
You know, I don't know if my 14-year-old son would agree with you about wanting to listen to my voice.
Well, her son agreed. We had him on the show. He was cool. That was a great show.
Because of what you do for a living, being calming gives people an opportunity. Mm-hmm.
Are you calm at home?
When I'm not going crazy asking everybody to, you know, clean up after themselves, then yes, I think I'm relatively calm.
So we were working yesterday, and I do a lot in my head, and I write a note or two. Tracy takes out her laptop. And she goes, wait, she's typing. She goes, wait, hold that thought. She's in the middle of talking. I've got another thought. And she starts typing. She's always going and going.
So
it's all in my head.
Yeah,
she's like the industrial,
I'm always in my head.
Like an industrial psychologist who tries to find out why you're not producing the way you should when you have the tools there. So
right,
you're giving them the tools to get to where they want.
Well, not necessarily. You know what? I'm more like an excavator. I excavate their psyche to find out who they really are and what they really want for their lives, what would bring them passion and purpose. That's really what it is.
You know how what's important about what you do? There's so many people in this world that are in jobs that they don't like.
Exactly.
And if you don't like what you do, you're never going to be successful in it.
Absolutely. My mother was
a
single mom.
Look, we're all here.
Right. Exactly. Enjoying it.
Yes.
You know, my mother was a single mother, and I always said to myself, you know, and she had secretarial jobs, but I always said to myself, wouldn't it be amazing if there was this tool that would have helped her, like, step into her passion and purpose? Because later in life, come to find out, she loves the medical industry. Loves
it.
I mean, my mother could have been a doctor.
Sure.
And I just wonder how many other people have that within them.
Thousands. You know, there are more people that want and very few people that do. And that technique, when you write, that's a technique that was taught to me in high school. When you're selling something and you write on paper, and you watch their eyes, and all you do is dibble-dabble on the paper, he'll tell you, I'll put stuff on napkins.
Oh, my God.
But there's a reason I do that.
What do you mean?
We should market Two Boys from Brooklyn napkins.
Fred was in a different business, and I had a big agency at the time, and I watched Freddie, and he would take out a napkin, and he could design the whole floor plan of what someone's thing's going to be, where the kitchen's going to be, where the grant's going to be.
Wow.
And I would say, and all these other people going like this with that, those little square papers. This is like 19 inches here. And Fred would go like this. Doesn't matter. This is what you want. I'll get it for you cheaper than anyone can get it for you. He said, so wait, take the napkin home. I was always afraid the lady would sneeze into the napkin. Hey, Fred, because Fred doesn't. My daughter is a big executive, and she has a laptop, she has that. But my daughter writes everything down, always writes her thoughts down and looks at it, and she trains salespeople. That's a great idea.
Very successful people write things down.
That's right.
Because you have so many thoughts during the day. How are you going to remember them all?
Never writes anything
down. Well, I remember everything. But
well, hold it.
Do you have like a photograph?
I do.
Freddie remembers what Freddie wants to remember.
No. I have a photographic memory.
Yeah, well,
everybody has, like, people's names. I can't.
I think your negative is bad.
That's Dr. Ihart, because I couldn't not remember another name.
That's why everyone has another name.
Oh, I want everyone as a witness. Where are you going to be tomorrow after the show?
Tomorrow's Tuesday, going to Pinozo's.
Everyone hear that?
There you go.
Yeah, but I'm not the one to cancel Wednesday.
I wasn't going to cancel Wednesday. Well, here's the deal.
Yeah.
I'll come in Wednesday, but I have a sure thing on Wednesday for the show. What do you tell me what you want me to do?
No, you can go as do my what partner, you want to do.
As my partner, tell me.
Go do what you got to do.
Would you rather have money or would you rather have honey?
Listen, I'd rather have
I'd rather
happiness.
Both.
Makes no difference.
Well, if you have the money, you can buy all the honey. So
you know what? That's a good question, because Tracy's assessment, that was one of the questions you have to answer.
You're pretty today.
Thank you.
I'm sorry, go ahead.
On her assessment.
Because I'm looking directly in your face, you look so pretty.
You have to answer this question of how you rate success?
Well, it's basically a compilation. The assessment is 32 questions. It's an online assessment. It takes about 20 minutes. And the way it asks the questions, it asks them in such a way that you can't trick the system.
I did try to sound smarter, but it didn't work.
Right, because it's like peeling back an onion. It asks you in various ways so that it gets to the bottom of what your truth is.
Well,
so Dawn's
like
truth
that.
Isn't going to be my truth.
When I first went to radio, we had to take that kind of
test.
You
want to talk into the mic? I know that you
I'm
think
talking
you're...
To Tracy.
But nobody can hear you.
I'm talking to Tracy. I don't care.
But nobody can hear you.
So, Tracy, let me ask you this question. When I had to take a psychological test to work for Jefferson Pilot,
he failed.
Oh no, it didn't matter. I failed. They wanted me.
He failed.
I remember that. They asked the same question 15 different ways, and I said, "Wait a second, didn't I answer that?" But it was.
It's designed that way.
Did you pass a test? I graduated freaking college. I had to pass something.
No, I know. You graduated by taking fencing and fly fishing.
Well, fencing was a
thing. Fencing. You almost stabbed yourself in the eye.
Oh, my gosh. I had to take fencing in middle school. I was so not coordinated.
At the University of Miami in 1964, it was $12 a credit. To get He's not. Wow. I took sailing. I took bowling. Yeah, I took bowling. We even took pool.
I took chemistry, I took P-Chem, I took calculus, and you're taking fencing.
I didn't take fencing.
I can't believe they gave you a degree.
Yes.
Oh, God, three Jews in the same room. I love it.
All right, listen, we got to take a break.
He brings all those Mama Goombas in that he has.
But if you want to call 1-800-888-9-0267, you can call and ask Tracy how to get your business started. You shut up.
I'm talking about three Jewish women.
Holy mackerel.
I love this.
All right, we'll be back. 1-800-889-0267.
Oh, my gosh. Big touche.
Please welcome a new sponsor to the show. It's AMP2 TV, the first and only internet network that's truly plugged in. When you're looking for a full-service internet television production company, discover AMP2 TV, a full-service production company that can provide all streaming videos in-studio or remotely. They offer web page development, and they use all the latest platforms to help make your business selling points more powerful. They can do remotes and live streaming, as well as tape productions. Let AMP2 TV handle all of your television production needs. Choose from a variety of creative TV and radio packages and see why AMP2 TV works with many major companies, including Comcast, Bravo, and Fox 29, as well as individuals and businesses of all types and sizes. To see samples of their work or to find out more, visit their website at amp2.tv. That's A-M-P, the number 2, dot TV. Or call them at 1-866-224-5422. That's 866-224-5422.
Have you ever had a business idea that you thought would be a great solution to tough challenges in today's world, but have no idea how to get started? You don't want to waste investment money on ideas that just don't work. Introducing Health and Wealth Seminars, a sophisticated advertising agency with over 40 years in the ad business. What makes Health and Wealth different from other agencies is they fit your product into the public's need. They help put together the strategy of your business before you commit thousands of dollars and just find out those ideas just don't work. Health and Wealth Seminars carry advertising contracts, radio and television contracts, and even a production service contract that will cover all of your business needs. Call today, 954-303-9563, and let Health and Wealth Seminars carry your business to the next level. The number is 954-303-9563. And remember that what happens when you don't advertise is nothing. 954-303-9563 is the number you need to get your business started in the right direction.
Hi, it's Leah, here to tell you about Dr. Anthony Pinozzo. He's a pain specialist located in Southern Palm Beach County, so if you are somebody that you know is suffering in pain, Dr. Pinozzo is the one you guys need to call. And make that call today, because living in pain is no way to go through life. Dr. Pinozzo has been in practice now for more than 49 years. He's treated more than 73,000 patients for pain. He's an expert when it comes to diagnosing the pain, and he has had huge turnarounds. In fact, people with living with scoliosis, he has had nearly a 100% turnaround. Lumbar pain as well. If you've got lower back pain, if you're suffering with migraines or flat feet pain, maybe pain in your elbows, your neck, your shoulders, Dr. Pinozzo can help you. And the greatest thing is he can help you without drugs, without surgery, and without having to go through weeks and months of rehabilitation. Give him a call today. Set up an appointment. It's 561-381-5800. Tune into his show Sundays, 11 to noon.
Is your child's tablet time greater than engaged activity time? Are you seeking better wellness strategies for your family? Do you want to redefine what your family's quality time looks like? At New Dawn Health Solutions, we focus on the four pillars of health coaching: lifestyle, exercise, attitude, and nutrition, to create a balanced approach to wellness. Together, we will open the conversation with you and your children on ways to empower healthy eating, increase physical activity, and set goals. Let's talk about the issues that are important to your family's health. Give New Dawn Health Solutions a call at 561-901-2854 or email us at dawn@newdawnhealthsolutions.com.
You're lunching with two boys from Brooklyn who invite you to advertise on the show. Share your good news. Just call 866-224-5422 and get all the information. There are plenty of options, and this could be a great chance to get the word out about your business or service. That's 866-224-5422. Now let's get back to those two boys from Brooklyn.
Dr. P, how you doing? Did you hear all those commercials?
That was a slew of commercials there. Boy,
man, your show yesterday was killer. You had a great show yesterday, my friend.
Yeah, I was awake for a change.
Yes, you were. I have to feed him with coffee and,
nice.
And Red Bull and knee-high, remember that drink? So, Doc, anything do you want to talk about today? Anything different?
Well, listen, on that program, we three react to each other because there's nothing written. Just comes right out, and I had a lady in here this morning, and they listened to the show and said it was a great show. And I said,
well, "Ooh, nice. Get that, Freddie?
Great.
Yeah, you had about a couple calls. That's great. Now, I want everyone to know, coming very soon into the New York area and probably all over the country, is Dr. Pinozzo is going to have his own reality show.
Really?
Yeah.
Nice.
And
wow.
It's going to be different than anything anyone has ever seen, because it's only going to be patients, nothing scripted. Him showing, talking about what the patient has, go through and showing what the patient feels like afterwards. And we're very excited about this. You know, it's Freddie and myself and Dr. P.
That's great.
Dr. P is a producer and a director and the stuntman. Right, Doc?
And the star.
You do it all.
Well, when New York hears that, you know, we have over 3 million impressions.
Wow.
In New York alone.
That's incredible. Doctor. That's amazing.
Well,
yeah. It's been good. You guys have been right along with me. I mean, without you, I couldn't do it.
So. Well, and you do good work. Without you, we couldn't advertise about you because you do good work.
These boys are great to work with, aren't they?
Oh, they're wonderful.
I'm going to show you this lady's picture. Now, we're going to be there, me and Freddie, tomorrow, right after our show, Doc.
Freddie is like a silent one, but, boy, he's got some real stuff to offer.
Oh, yeah.
Freddie, yeah.
Phrase it.
And that's his business, to offer all this funny stuff. So.
Yes, he's a funny guy.
Who, Freddie?
No, Freddie's the silent one. You know what they say.
Yeah, what happens is Freddie is an expert on athletes, being a coach and doing all that work, so he always adds a part about some of the athletes that got hurt. Doc, it was good talking to you.
He's gone.
Dak, where'd you go?
He fainted.
Tracy, imagine analyzing these two. We've got silent one, and we've got the verbal
one. The deadly
one,
silent but deadly.
That sounds
smart. Imagine what their assessments would show.
See, I always said to my father, I said, Dad, one day I'm going to be a millionaire because I cannot live the way we're living now. And I said, I am going to do it. And I knew what my expertise was. My expertise was sales. And all I had to do over the years was find, like, if I knew you then, it would have taken me a shorter time,
mm-hmm.
you know, to find out that part of it that I didn't know, which you know. If you were around, I would have been a zillionaire.
That's the whole point. It's like taking the assessment is like taking the shortcut. You know, the shortcut mm-hmm. to finding what your passions and not necessarily your passions, but what your strengths are.
Right.
So somebody can be high in leadership and vision, but not necessarily know how to implement.
Right.
You know, some of those basic jobs that we were speaking about when the show first started, these are all people that are so high off the charts in customer service. You know, then you have your people that are high in sales, like you. You have your people that are also, like you, high in marketing, PR. Mm-hmm. You know, you have so many different areas, but I think that even students, they come out of school, and they really don't know what their forte is. So, like, if I would have taken my own assessment
mm-hmm.
about 20-something years ago, I would have known that my forte was in marketing and PR. Maybe I would have majored in communications. Instead, I went to the School of Life and learned it.
Well,
ended up in the same place. Maybe it would have been sooner rather than later.
Was this your passion to help people like this? Or
this is my total passion. This and this in organizing clothing and pantry closets. Don't ask.
Want to come over?
Don't ask. I love that. Like, you don't know. I could totally get lost in a
organizing
closet.
You come over to my house, you quit to my closet. My wife goes like this, I can't do it anymore. I can't do it anymore. He's got clothes back from 1960 and we'll get rid of them.
Well, you never know. One
it
day.
Could come back.
Exactly.
Bounce, bounce,
it might come back.
I still have from the 60s bell bottoms. It's going to come back.
It's going to come
That's
back. We were out
bell
for dinner.
Bottoms are coming back.
Oh, man.
We were at a bar Friday night and it was a local high school. It was their 30th high school reunion and there was a guy in his tracksuit from high school and it clearly did not fit. Made me think of what you have in your closet.
Oh, God, my wife says, well, I have jeans. My wife says, you're the only person I know of all the friends that has 30 pairs of jeans. 36 waist, 34 waist, 32 waist in different colors.
Is that for when you're physically reinventing yourself?
I am physically, yes. I'm physically always reinventing myself, always.
How about shoes? How many pairs of shoes do you have?
I don't have a lot of shoes. I have five pairs of sneakers, a pair of black shoes, pair of tuxedo shoes, two pair of brown shoes, and that's it.
Wow. How about you, Freddie?
Well, I work out, so I always have sneakers.
See, Tracy.
How many shirts do you
have? I won't even ask.
So I want to bring up a subject. So on the cover of Consumer Reports, I was checking out at the newsstand.
Oh, I have that all the time. I get that every month.
Did you see the one where they were talking about students who were graduating college are now questioning why they even went to college?
Yes.
Oh, my God.
Well, when you come out of school with a $250,000 bill.
Exactly.
You sort of have to question lots of things.
Exactly. So it made me think about, like, the assessment, I mean, what a small investment it is to take an assessment that'll help you identify
your strengths and skills.
What's that?
Did you take loans out?
Doc, are you still on?
I did not.
Did you take loans?
No.
Did you take loans?
No, it was $12 a credit.
I see that the problem is that life has changed. You know,
exactly.
When you see a $250,000 bill, you're like, that means I got to get a job to pay this back?
So taking a three-credit course when I went to school was $36. I think now at the University of Miami, it's like $250 a credit.
Right.
It's about, I think, $40,000 a semester for tuition.
Yeah.
But we don't have the time to waste anymore. You know, the kids that are coming out of school or people later in life who want to reinvent and go back to school, it's so important to find out your passion sooner rather than later. Because it could really save years.
And money.
And time and money.
Well, I think AARP, didn't they change the R to reinventing from retirement? I really think they did.
What does it stand for?
I think it's reinventing now instead of retirement.
What's the AA stuff?
American Association of Retired People.
But I think they changed the R. Now I think it's reinventing.
Well, you know what? You know what they call?
Because no one's retiring.
Do you know what they call?
Oh, very true. No one is retiring anymore at 65. Very few people retired. So I'm 74.
Can't retire. You can't afford to retire.
You look great.
You left her speechless.
I work out every day. No, but it's true. It's not that you can't afford to retire.
Some people cannot, though.
Why don't you retire?
My feeling of retirement is that when you retire, you die. And I'll tell you why. Because you're not keeping your brain working.
I agree. That's true.
Whether we're doing this, it's keeping my brain working. Whether I'm going to see Dr. Pinozzo and putting deals together, it keeps your mind going.
I agree.
It doesn't matter if you work out. Mm-hmm. It's your mind. That's the most important part of your body. You're dead.
My next door neighbor in Brooklyn, you know, was like the brick buildings, and we shared the gate.
Oh, God.
He retired and died immediately afterwards. And that always stuck in my mind.
My cousin passed away at 78 years old. He was fat, and he didn't care about anything anymore. And when he was working and younger, he had a mission. He was a sales guy.
Right.
And he wanted to keep in shape when you were selling because you want to look good when you go into to see accounts. And he just went to pot. Not the kind that you have. He totally went to pot and he got really, and he died.
Hey, honey.
Wow. Yes,
that's
baby.
Why. Just don't retire, Dr. G. Keep your mind young.
And if guys like your husband, when they retire, they become professors.
Oh, you could become a professor. Or an expert.
Yeah. My gastroenterologist also is a professor at the University of Miami, teaching his craft. And we're the same age, and he's running around like crazy. And, you know, we both went to a high school reunion. This is a true story. And I'm going to let you talk again, but you'd appreciate this. We went to a high school reunion. That was our 50-year reunion. And people were coming up to him and myself and saying, you guys look the same. Except for the beard and a couple of wrinkles. What do you guys do? Do you have plastic? I said, no. And then as we're going through the line to eat, the ones that asked me that, they were eating the cake. And I don't eat that at 12 o'clock at night. I had fruit and a cup of tea because I don't want to be up. I said, and my guy said to me, that's why we look like this.
Right.
The queen of our school was wearing orthopedic sneakers. And she was the queen of our high school.
Wow.
Dawn is weaning
and
you
I
off.
Didn't even bang her. And that was the hardest part. She did when I had the shot.
On another note, Dawn is weaning me off of all kinds of sugars and fats. It's interesting because last night I took my 7-year-old to Publix.
Oh, now I see that New York accent coming out. I love it. I took my kid to Publix.
And we're going up and down the aisles. And I started showing him the food labels because he's pointing at everything that has food coloring and a gazillion grams of sugar. And I thought of you, Dawn. And I started showing him the food labels. And he understood.
That's
he said,
great.
Well, can we get the one that has, like, he actually contributed to the conversation.
The kids, they get it. You just
he
have to teach them.
That's exactly it. So I think our next excursion should be with you.
We'll do a smart shopping.
I think we need to do that.
Do a smart shopping trip.
You need
trip.
To start
you know,
that program.
That's something to put on camera and do a show
that
about.
That would be amazing.
You're going to follow this one with a
absolutely.
Camera.
Absolutely.
I know where I'm going, too.
I don't have the patience.
I'm going to the
I will literally
counter.
Hold the camera.
I don't have the patience for that.
I'm volunteering.
To follow me around the grocery store. We can run our carts down,
Freddie.
I have
a different philosophy about all this.
Yeah, we know your philosophy about eating.
It is. Listen, I go to the supermarket, and I open up anything I want to eat. I don't care what it is. It could be crackers. It could be cheese.
How about frozen foods?
Except frozen foods because it's frozen.
You're one of those guys.
But anything else, yeah. I go down the aisle and people look at me. Says, you want some? Then don't look at me.
He eats it.
Wait, hold it.
He opens it and eats it.
You open the box of cereal and eat it?
Anything. Absolutely.
That's against the law.
No, it's not. I'm going to pay for it. But I can't. I got to wait till I leave the store to eat it.
What I do with fruit, if there's grapes and it's $5.95 a pound for grapes, I open them up and I take 3 grapes to test it.
No.
If they're sweet, I buy them.
I buy I buy the box. No. I take the bag and I open it and I'm eating it. And Linda's like turning colors. Like, you can't do that. I said, watch. You know, wine, I open up
no
soda.
Way. There's no way. Where do you get the wine thing to open it up?
Publix has a whole wine thing.
Where do you get the screw thing to open it?
I may buy Manischewitz, the ones with
the screw top.
Manischewitz. don't drink Manischewitz.
You.
No, the drunks. You ever see the bums? You see the bums? And I always thought the bums were Jewish. They're sitting there drinking Manischewitz wine.
Whatever.
I was eating Rugula. I get him a buck.
They sell corkscrews in the supermarket,
too. You can't take the corkscrew open a bottle of wine. You're crazy.
And what's with those little corkscrews, by the way? Who can actually figure those out?
That's easy. They bought me because I'm a wine drinker. My daughter bought me the Houdini. You put it on, you screw it, pops it right out.
That's
know what I'm talking about?
There's one that's called the rabbit.
The rabbit.
Yeah, the lever over. Yeah.
You put it, you screw it up, opens it right away.
Yeah, the ones they have in the mini bars, those don't work.
No.
And why is there a hole in the top?
Because you're supposed to push it down. we'll talk about that later. Why? What
it's
are you doing? Don't do that.
Through it so you can twist it.
I think you're right. I think you put like a stick through the hole so you can turn it, right?
But anyway, the whole point of the story was that, you know, I see everybody reading labels and I understand all of that. But to me, food is fun. And when you take the fun out of it, Les, ain't nobody asking you to follow me.
My son was having soda yesterday, 40 grams of sugar.
Okay, soda.
You know what that is? That's 10 teaspoons of sugar in a can.
I understand.
1984 is the last time I had any soda.
A soda will explode.
That's awesome.
But
the worst thing in the world, soda.
When I was growing up, Gatorade, it's the worst thing in the world.
Oh, it still is all that sugar.
Worst thing in the world.
Yeah.
Worst thing in the
you
world.
You ever seen these girls at the bars that have a Red Bull with vodka?
Yes.
Oh, my gosh. You know what that does to you? Can you imagine what that does to your body?
Kills you.
Wow.
Wow.
But I'm not going to, as Dr. Nutt is drinking Dr. Pepper, but I'm not.
How many grams of water in that Dr.
Pepper? And I'm proud.
And that's not even one serving size. That's probably two.
Do you know how much sugar is in that bottle?
My daughter, I convinced my daughter.
69 grams of sugar.
You know what that is?
Lisa hasn't had a soda.
Divide it by four.
Those are those.
It's delicious.
Those are those packets. You ever seen those packets?
If I go to a place.
Splenda packets? That's one
else. I used to love pizza.
That's 69 of those.
With a Coke.
Nice.
You care? You don't care.
I just.
What I'm saying.
Yeah.
So having fun.
He's healthier than me, and this guy eats cheeseburgers and French fries.
I went to Limburg's yesterday. I had cheeseburgers.
I go with him. I eat an egg white omelet with spinach and turkey.
That's right.
Right? The turkey sausage. Yeah.
That's right. Then you go to the bathroom and you barf, and I'm like, let's go back and eat some more. I have murder burgers. I'll eat that. You know, listen, it's all about having fun. I'm not reading labels. I'm done with that. The harder I tried to stay healthy, I got diabetes. When I got off of the healthy, doc says, take her off the pills. That's what happens.
No.
I'm telling you the truth.
I can't even.
Well, I have kidney disease and Crohn's disease.
This guy has more disease than health.
I was born with one kidney. So I really, I mean, my salt contact is almost nil.
And I hate salt. I hate pretzels. I hate anything with
and
salt.
Sugar, I don't. I mean,
how'd
I
you
really,
guys grow up with the pretzels in New York without salt?
They sell pretzeless.
Saltless.
Yeah, but have some salt. Okay. Here's what you're gonna do. What you do in the reading of labels. That's where you're smart.
I do take the salt off my pretzels, but
inside
I think I'm one
that
of the
stuff
only.
That they make, the dough has salt in it.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Because you have to put the salt in there for flavor. You just put the yeast and the gluten crap. My wife had problems with her stomach for years. She doesn't have celiac disease. Ever since she's been free of gluten.
Gluten-free.
She's had, man, I'm telling you. And we found this thing called the Gluten Market, where they ship the food in cold from all over the country.
Oh, wow.
In Davie, they just opened a gluten-free bakery. I'm going to bring them in. It's just so expensive.
I'm bringing bagels in with a lot of calories and gluten.
A donut. So I cheat once a week, and she does. It's vegan gluten-free donut.
Vegan gluten. There you go.
$5 donut.
It's so good.
Eat that.
I just got an email saying you just made the club where you get a free donut. My wife said, "How many freaking donuts do you buy?" I said, "I bought two for you, one for me." It was $15. It was $18.
What kind of donut?
It's vegan and gluten-free.
What's it taste like?
It really tastes good. That's the crazy part about it.
Hey, listen.
I asked her how much calories and how much sugar is in it. She said we don't use sugar, we use honey.
Oh, there's no sugar in honey.
But honey's healthy. It
goes, yeah, there's no sugar in honey.
You know, honey's the only thing that never goes. You can keep honey for 100 years, it never it's never bad.
There's also a can of.
A little bit, but it doesn't go bad.
It doesn't what? Doesn't go bad?
We'll be ready for Rosh Hashanah then in September.
Yeah.
What about that can of. What's the name of Spam?
That never goes bad.
Never goes bad.
Never goes bad.
Can you imagine? Have you ever eaten Spam,
Tracy?
No.
Tracy, can you imagine when I was a kid?
I bet Freddie has.
Oh, yeah,
you know what we used to have for meat? Spam with eggs. I mean, you want to talk about a glutton for punishment? We used to have white rice, Spam, and eggs.
Spam burger.
Something funny? You know what the
biggest
Spam
burger.
You know where all this, see how good you are.
And with cheese?
Where's the most amount of Spam sold in the
South
world?
South America.
Nope.
In the world,
probably in the U.S. somewhere.
Not in the U.S.
No. Russia.
Well, it's in the U.S. It's one. It's one of the last states to be inaugurated.
Hawaii.
They're one of their biggest selling things is Spam. When they make their sushi, it's all with Spam. Spam sushi.
Did you see how they reduce the spam? They go reducing sodium. So instead of having 10,000 grams of sodium, it only has 5.
How many grams of sodium is in a 4-ounce serving of Spam?
How much?
More than 2,100 grams of Spam.
And do you still eat Spam?
No, I can't find it. But I went
everywhere.
Oh, I know what. I bet the dollar store has it.
I go out of my way to find it.
I bet the dollar store has it.
The dollar store?
Yeah, you get it for a dollar. You can die for a dollar. By 5, you'll die 5 times even more.
Listen, you could go outside and get hit by a bus.
Yeah, but at least when I die, God,
You start taking that medicine.
Just in your backpack. We're good.
What's wrong with you? You start taking your medicine, it's killing you. I don't know what you're talking about.
It's I have reactions to the medicine, but my last colonoscopy showed me that that the inflammation is fine.
Right.
So I'm trading off one thing. So that's if you saw me naked, I have a little pimples on here, and that's why I'm wearing long pants.
That's what Tracy needs to see.
That's what you
want to
see.
Naked.
But hey, listen. They want to find Tracy.
One second.
She's right here. She's like, well, she
listen,
here?
Before
she?
We get to that, Connecticut
find
is,
Elmo? She's
Connecticut,
right
is
here.
Connecticut is in jury duty. She couldn't get out.
Yeah.
And she is at lunch. Too much talking over each other. That's gotta improve. Sounds amateurish. That's coming from Connecticut.
Wow, Connecticut.
Connecticut, I hope they put you on the case and you don't come out of there for 10
Connecticut,
years.
If you're watching, Nutter is going to be the new host.
Nutter's very quiet in there.
Yeah, Nutter's great. He took a Dramamine.
Yeah. All right, well, Tracy, how do we find you?
She's right here. Oh, how do we
find her services.
How do we find
so
your
you
services?
Can find me on my website.
Which is
www.kawacommunitypartners, K-A-W-A, community, C-O-M-M-U-N-I-T-Y, partners, PARTNERS.com. It's like Kawasaki without the sake.
That's funny.
Really
That's
like strange. That.
And
strangely funny.
If you go to my website, you can also download a free copy of my ebook, which is the first pillar of reinvention, where you can read all about stepping into your purpose.
That's it, Les.
What? I'm sorry.
I'm going to step into my purpose.
Oh, please.
I stepped in dog duty. I mean,
it only took me, I don't know, 30
what were you
years
before, what
to get
were you
here?
Before you met her?
Before I met Tracy? I did medical billing for 12 years.
Wow.
I was a special ed teacher. I did medical billing.
Wow, you're smart.
So it took Tracy's for
Dawn
you?
Has, to... No. Dawn but has her master's.
I do have a Dawn's master's in special smart. Ed and a health
you
coach.
You have an MBA?
I have a master's in education.
Wow.
So let me ask you a question.
You're a smart.
But my undergrad was in communications. In 1989.
All that good stuff came.
Got me back here.
All that good stuff came because you met Tracy.
But isn't that interesting about the reinvention part? So
yes.
That part, I didn't know that you went to school for communication. So this is so apropos. But imagine
Tracy
knowing.
When I started working with you boys at about the same time.
Oh, really?
Exactly.
Tracy, I met her 3 years ago. And I said, you should be on TV. And you know what she did? She turned around and walked out of the
she
room.
Told us the story yesterday.
I'm like,
it took three times of asking her.
I get tired
and then
of
here
asking.
She is.
Really? True story.
True story.
Why?
Because I thought...
Oh, why?
I thought, why?
Yes.
And then everyone said, well, why not? And I went, okay, why not? And here I am.
So actually...
I'm glad someone said, why not?
I'm going to use a word that Frey doesn't know, but you go, actually, it was a mitzvah that you met her.
It was beshert.
It's beshert. You don't know anything but talking about you, Puerto Rican.
It was the universe. It was beshert. By the third time, I said, I'm here.
Well, Frey came out and said, I'm here and I'm queer.
You know, he's taking off his headset.
Where's he going?
Still, I know.
Yeah, he's just, I want to say thank you very much. The show's almost
he's
over.
He's wrapped up and he's going.
I have to go look for a new car. My wife said if I don't get a car by next week, she's going to buy me the smart car. You know, the car that's so big.
That's a good car.
Yeah, it is.
People like you can't get out of it, though.
I can't get. Did I tell what happened? Well, I tried out a Corvette. I got in there and I said, wow, to my wife, is Margaret. I said, this is great. Oh, man, I love it. Honey, could you get the salesman over here? I couldn't get out of it. Well, you get old. I mean, I had a Corvette for years, and now it's hard to get out when you get older. I know what's happening. I did all those squats
really?
That those
he
girls
He makes that
did.
Too
this
easy.
This is a guy that goes to the gym. He can't even get out of his car. This is what I'm telling you, Tracy. You can't believe nothing this guy tells you. All right, listen, we got to go there, big boy. Now that you're all packed up, and you put your Geritol. Put your Geritol in your pocket. Tracy, I want to thank you for coming down and having fun.
Thank you for having me.
I'm the only
this
one
thing
that,
thing
that I take
experience.
Viagra.
Just ignore him. Ignore him. He takes Viagra, he thinks it's aspirin.
I don't want to fall out of bed.
He takes Viagra because he thinks it's aspirin. Oh but Tracy, thank you for coming.
Thank you, Tracy,
it's a pleasure
for coming.
Having you.
We'll have you back.
We will have her back.
We will see you guys tomorrow. Who do we have tomorrow?
Us.
Oh, we'll bring somebody.
We'll bring somebody.
No, are you going to be here tomorrow? No?
No.
She's not coming back tomorrow, is she?
I hope so.
I don't think so.
I got kids to take care of.
No, but she gets called back, Freddie.
You got kids to take care of. You can bring them in here. All right, listen. We got to go.
Want free lunch at Lexus?
He's out here.
We will see you tomorrow. He's
a maniac. Sandwiches. I got an hour.
Say goodbye.
Have a great day. Wrap up your lunch, and we will see you tomorrow.
Maybe.
That's about it for today's lunch break with two boys from Brooklyn. You're invited to join the break every day, Monday through Friday at 12 noon. So, if you missed some of the good stuff they served up today, there's more coming next time. Bring your lunch and the boys from Brooklyn will bring the smiles. And it's all live. See you next time. Now, go and enjoy the rest of your day.